Hi, I am Nias Ali Shaukat. This video will be discussing about the topic COVID-19 and civil engineering. In this topic, you will be able to understand the main things to be remembered for civil engineers in view of recent pandemic outbreak COVID-19. Being this a worldwide crisis and affected all sort of human habitat, it is relevant to contribute the ideas of respective branches of study for managing during the crisis and afterwards. I'll be focusing only the civil engineering aspects with related to COVID-19 outbreak through the eyes of a civil engineer, which may not be the strategy of the government machineries. For authentic health measures and standards, you can refer the respective government portals. These are some of the online courses I did, which were conducted by United Nations World Health Organization related to COVID-19 outbreak. I would like to thank Mr. Abhay Shankar, District Youth Coordinator, Nehru Yuva Kendra, Kannur, who gave immense support for completing these courses. The main idea of this video is to open up a discussion to study seriously the relevant aspects of crisis management in civil engineering, which can do at the midst of the crisis, COVID-19 and afterwards. Moreover, we have to consider this pandemic crisis management activities as a reference for our future, for understanding the flaws happen and do research to solve those with active participation of stakeholders involved in managing the crisis. All the relevant details are trying to put forward in brief. You can also share your ideas under the comments for an active discussion about the concepts. In short, the whole idea is to explore the difficulties faced, innovation, simulation, renovation of ideas and document the understandings for future reference. Coronavirus disease or COVID-19 is an infectious disease caused by newly discovered coronavirus. To avoid the infection, protect yourself and others from infection by washing your hands or using an alcohol-based rub frequently and not touching your face. The COVID-19 virus spreads primarily through droplets of saliva or discharge from the nose when an infected person coughs or sneezes. At this time, there are no specific vaccines or treatments for COVID-19. There is a wide message we have shared during the lockdown, which says, until now, the best vaccine against COVID-19 is made by civil engineers, that is our home. That is the relevance of this topic. So we have a social responsibility to be well equipped, always to act during the crisis and study from it to act more vigilantly in future. So to find the difficulties faced during the crisis, there should be a thorough survey to be undertaken, and positively we have to collect the ground reality by discussing the authorities and volunteers who had actively participated in this crisis. Major issues which I pointed out are: there are many hospitals or public buildings or residential buildings are not equipped for addressing the issues like hygiene, space, ventilation, energy efficiency, etc. We were not prepared or forecast such a pandemic crisis and relevance with the construction industry. Even though we are designing our buildings for 100 years, we were unable to forecast such situations. Hence, we have to research such crises which may happen in future. While structural designing, we are considering adverse load conditions. Likewise, we have to do construction activities to resist or to reduce the effect of all possible crisis situations. Mainly two situations happen in the crisis related to construction industry. The first one is we have to do mitigation activities during the crisis for providing proper and rapid accommodation to medical activities. The second one is the business on this industry and livelihood of the laborers and their health concerns. We have to study from the flaws and strength from the crisis happen, include such ideas in our construction practices. Appropriate construction materials have to be ascertained in advance. We have to ensure effective and hygienic water supply with the testing facilities during the crisis and afterwards. A self-sustained water waste management system in their respective dwelling should be promoted. Road and public domain has to be made suitable for disinfection activities like proper drains, slopes, avoid mixing with fresh water, the chemical reaction with the existing sewage, the furniture and finishes that is given in the public space should be easily cleanable, etc. So far, no burial guidance were recommended specifically for COVID-19 by WHO, even though documented guidelines are given for other pandemic outbreaks. Hence, geotechnical engineers can come forward to study the natural soil as well as the other relevant properties of the soil and ascertain the depth of burial to be taken. We have to predict more combinations of situations like these while we are in lockdown. If earthquake happens, what remedies we have to take, or do we need to stay at home or run away from the home? Or if a flood happens in this situation, what strategy we need to formulate? Certain protocols we have to formulate to address such situations. Artificial intelligence have to be utilized to process the mass data available. For example, the percentage of patients affected from their family members in their respective residence with respect to space available in their residence. Hence, like that, we could find many interesting findings from these mass data to formulate the recommendation to government to modify or implement in their policies. After doing all preparedness, we have to do a mock drill or simulation study to ensure how prepared we are to address the crisis. The construction practices need to be formulated with the experience we gained from the current situations. Authorities could be able to predict which kind of dwelling can be used as an isolation or quarantine purpose, or which building can be converted into hospital rapidly. Such a classification should be made while approving the plan itself, and it should be exhibited clearly in the building. In China, they made two temporary hospitals within a span of 10 days, which accommodated 1,000 to 1,500 patients. Because of the quick response they had made by arranging raw materials and execute with skilled labors. But we have to also keep in mind, in another incident, the hotel the China authorities had selected for quarantine was collapsed, which led to the death of about 30 people due to poor building selection. And this will also cause troubles in stopping the spread of virus also. In a residential building, proper entry hygienic point to be made so that person or goods entering in the building can be maintained hygienic. Room and moving space to be made in such a way that an isolated person could able to move without contacting other person in the building. Foldable furniture could be promoted, hence rooms can be converted into exercise, activity room, room for working or studying, etc. Large opening should be ensured in order to get proper lighting and ventilation. Energy efficient building are relevant, being people will start to spend more time in residence than going outside due to spread of viruses. Hence, the expenses and pollution can be controlled. In public building like hospitals, certain criteria has given by WHO. These should be having proximity with all relevant facilities like medicines, water, waste disposal, other resources, etc. An easy movement to reach the facility should be ensured. This building should have proper patient's entrance, triage or diagnosing area, treatment area, which is the mix-up area, and staff area, which should be restricted area with the separate entrance. Proper access should be there between these areas. As per WHO, the room size for critical or severe person to be kept 9.6 square meter with a dimension likely 3 meter by 3.2 meter. Door with 1.2 meter for proper movement of hospital bed and stretchers should be ensured. With reference to these points, I believe the conversion of railway coaches to isolation or treatment facility would face space constraints as per WHO recommendation. Size of hospital bed as well as stretchers should be kept in mind while selecting the buildings for temporary hospitals. Lift size, corridor size, room size, ramps, etc. to be ensured before finalizing the temporary hospitals. WHO recommends natural ventilation at a rate of 60 liters per second per person to be given in the hospital's common area, and for severe or critical patient room, hybrid ventilation of 160 liters per second per person to be ensured. Floor finishes and furniture uses in the hospital needs to be easily cleanable. the people who build the exhibition halls, they could able to rapidly make the temporary hospitals at the midst of the crisis. In future, all the other public buildings should be made in such a way to act in crisis for isolation or temporary hospitals. In order to maintain proper hygiene in public buildings, effective drains, waste management, space, ventilation, etc. should be considered. The selection of furniture and finishes like flooring, painting, etc. are relevant. That should be able to clean properly. In bus, train, airship, terminals and all other public buildings need the screening points, which should be separated from other areas, and as said earlier, the finishes need to be taken care of. Effective after-action review need to be made for finding the flaws and analyze the aspects, for not for blaming any authorities. This will act as a reference for formulating action plans. Such a well-documented review can be submitted to the government for necessary implementation and future disaster management. In conclusion, I would like to brief what we were discussing. So with all the data available related to the civil engineering aspects, the technical details need to be documented. And these data available in public domain throws light to many researchers to do their work more effectively. Periodically need to perform simulation in order to understand our strength. After action review to be done in order to submit to the government for formulating necessary policies. I hope this video would open up the discussion of the importance of civil engineer in the crisis management in the wake of COVID-19. I definitely know I might have not included some relevant points with respect to this topic. Hence, kindly share your valuable comments. Stay home and stay safe. Thank you.